In Monolix, it is easy to implement delayed differential equations with the function delay. This function allows to delay a dynamical variable by a constant time. The time can be a number, for example 3, or a parameter that can be estimated, for example here a parameter tau, but it has to stay constant over time. The dynamical variable must be defined in a derivative equation in the model, and the function delay must also be used directly in a derivative equation. It is a good practice to define the initial conditions of the delayed differential equation system, like on this example. If an initial condition is not defined, it is set to the default value 0. Notice that it is possible to have varying initial conditions if the initial values can be analytically computed. For example, x can be defined as a linear variable of time between -3 and 0, like this. Let's have a look at a very simple example. Here, a model with a delay is written in MLXtran, the modeling language of the MonolixSuite. A dynamical variable x is defined with a first-order delayed differential equation. This corresponds to an accumulation process with a delayed linear elimination treatment. Let's now simulate this model in MLExplorer, the application of the MonolixSuite dedicated to model exploration. Given these parameter values, the simulation of the model is performed with a delayed differential equation solver and results in this curve. We can see here that the delay implements a negative feedback which constrains the stability of the system. Let's now have a look at a more complex example. Delays can be used to implement lifespan models. These models describe a population of cells by cell production and cell degradation rate, where the cell degradation rate is equal to the cell production rate delayed by the lifespan of the cell. Lifespan-based indirect response model combine this assumption with the effect of a drug concentration C, for example here an inhibition of the production rate. This response can for instance be the number of blood cells. The degradation rate then also depends on the drug concentration, but with a delay. The response is defined with this differential equation. Here is an example of such a model written in MLExtran with the response part in black. The rest of the model in gray includes a very simple PK model for the drug amount AC and drug concentration CC. Here the amount AC is defined in the derivative equation, not CC, so only AC can be used in the function delay. The delay duration is a parameter TR that can be estimated by Monolix. Finally, note that to implement delays in the absorption after drug administration, instead of the delay function, it is much more convenient to use the keyword TLAG in the administration macros, for example, the macro absorption. It defines a delay that can be used in analytical solutions or ordinary differential equations. You can find more information on using the function delay or on lifespan-based indirect response models on our online documentation. See you next week!